Hi, I'm Frank Salatis, and welcome to Coffee Break Project Management. This session, we are going to be talking about a few formulas in earned value management that you might experience when you're taking the PMP, Project Management Professional Certification Exam. So I'm going to give you some tips and techniques on how to remember these formulas to give you a little bit of an edge when you're preparing for and actually taking the exam. So what I'd like to do is show you how these particular formulas actually work and give you a way to kind of keep them in mind and use this as a memory jogger. Now, you'll notice on my chart here that I'm using what I refer to as industry standard acronyms, and I have that for a reason, and I'm going to walk through these formulas, and it will give you a very easy way to remember these formulas while you're studying. Now, our first acronym, BCWP, means budgeted cost of work performed. And our second acronym, ACWP, means actual cost of work performed. Okay? Now, budgeted cost of work performed means that this is the amount that you had planned to pay for work that had been done or performed. And actual cost of work performed means this is what you paid for the work that you performed. Now, the PMI acronym that you might see on the exam is EV, which means earned value, and AC, which means actual cost. Now, the thing to remember about this is that we will subtract the actual cost from the earned value or the budgeted cost of work performed. And what we're doing here is that we are comparing budgeted cost to actual cost. So right there in that formula, if you can remember budgeted cost and actual cost, what you're doing is you are subtracting what you paid from what you had planned to pay as part of your actual project plan. Okay, a quick example of that would be if your budgeted cost of work performed was $1,000 and your actual cost was $900. If we subtract 900 from 1,000, what we have here is a plus 100 or a cost variance savings. Okay, so in this particular case, what you are is actually under budget. Now, if we take a look at this second formula here, again, we're using budgeted cost of work performed, which also means earned value, and we are now comparing that with budgeted cost of work scheduled, also known as planned value. In this particular situation, what we are doing is we are comparing the work that was performed with the work that was scheduled to be performed. So what we're doing here is that we're basically looking at what we had planned to pay for the work that we had actually performed and comparing that with what we had planned to pay for work that should have been performed. So what we're doing here is we're comparing work performed with work that was scheduled to be performed. The example here would be if we are using $1,000 for our earned value and we were supposed to complete $1,200 worth of work. If we take the $1,200 from the $1,000, what we wind up with is a schedule variance of minus $200, which basically means that we might be under budget, but we are behind schedule by $200 or 200 units of measurement when it comes to our plan. So these are pretty easy to remember. Remember, budgeted cost compared to actual cost, and work performed compared with work that was scheduled to be performed. So it's pretty easy to remember these. Now, if we're interested in the performance indices, the formulas are relatively the same. If you can take a look at these formulas, we are looking at budgeted cost of work performed, but in this case, we're dividing that by the actual cost of work performed, or this becomes EV divided by AC. That will provide for us what is known as a cost performance index. And this is basically a measure of efficiency in the amount of work that we are doing and how well we're spending our money. So if we take $1,000 here, okay, and just for example, if the actual cost was also $1,000, if I divide 1,000 by 1,000, I will get a performance index of 1, which means that there is no variance. Same thing we can do for the Schedule Performance Index, in this case, it is the earned value or budgeted cost of work performed divided by the budgeted cost of work scheduled, which is our planned value. And in this particular case, what we're looking to see is what's the efficiency in the way we are managing our time and our schedule. Now, if we have a $1,000 here, okay, and we divide that by 900 here, what this is basically saying is that 1,000 divided by 900 will give us basically a 1.1, which would tell us that we are ahead of schedule and we're actually very efficient in the use of our time and our schedule. Now, another thing that you can remember about these formulas is if you can remember our budgeted cost of work performed minus actual cost of work performed and budgeted cost of work performed minus budgeted cost of work scheduled, okay, the formulas look almost identical. Something that you can just keep in mind to help you remember this is just put a dot above and below the minus sign on each of these formulas for the performance indices, and you have your four basic formulas for earned value, which will be helpful when you're studying for the exam. So review these, practice a few times. It's always a good idea to practice for the exam, but this will certainly give you a little bit of a memory jogger as you're planning for the exam. I hope you can use this information. I hope you find it useful, and we'll see you again next time on another edition of Coffee Break Project Management. Thank you.